in the audience as if you, because you actually have been members of the audience as well, growing up in England and in Europe, as well as now performers. Can you tell us the difference between, like, say, a European audience and the American audience?
European audiences tend to be sort of very, not conservative, but a bit sort of hard to impress. The American audiences are very spontaneous.
Now, is that right across the board? In other words, is it different in the English audience, as opposed to an audience here in Montreux or in Germany or whatever?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. Definitely.
You might say?
Yes, sir, yeah.
You all are together on that answer?
Oh, yeah, we agree with that.
not saying the English are miserable, but they're very, they clap them, and what can you do next, you know? You feel obliged to be 100% entertaining all the time, and we're not 100% entertaining all the time.
No. Being here in Montreux, what does that actually do for one's career, if you can explain that to American
audience? Gives you a suntan.
Yeah.
No,
gets
seriously.
Gets you a good view. Gets you out of the house.
Well, that's all cute, but I mean, seriously, what does it do for you professionally?
I'd imagine it just exposes you to so many people, you know, because the audience is so big, you know, for TV, you know, worldwide, and the nuclear rain's coming down there. Yeah. It's probably, like, for our careers, really, really good, you know.
Gets to, what, millions of people all over Europe?
It's probably 60 million.
You have to understand, the American audience is not hip to Montreux. I mean, we have certain things that we do over there that I'm sure that you wouldn't be familiar with over here. Mm-hmm. So we're trying to explain this to the American audience as to the impact.
Throughout Europe, this is probably the biggest TV show of its kind, you know?
Is that right?
Yeah, I'd say about 60 million people.
Come in!
Another thing about these mountains, they're great. Great big mountains.
Great, yeah. Yep. That's what a mountain usually is. All right. We're going to the motels right now. Martha Davis and Company, MTV on location in Montreux, Switzerland. We're getting out of this match now. TV. We're rocking Montreux all weekend long. We got three members, Alan, Tony, and John from the Outfield. Your record played deep. Solid gold. It is gone in the United States, right? Number 18 in Holland. All right, number 10 in the United States, right?
Yes.
I don't know if you know it or not, but it is now certified solid gold on its way to platinum. We want to actually help you celebrate that fact, right? So MTV, as we're here in Montreux, Switzerland.
Oh, it is.
But we do it a class act, right, for a class act.
What can
act.
We say?
Champers.
Well, thank you.
This is no lager, right?
Thank you, MTV.
Thank you, MTV.
Thank you. Is it Dom Perignon?
One of the great things about this, too, is that we understand that we might have to do this a number of times. We might have to do this again in a couple of months because the record is 800,000.
Oh, if we have to, okay.
It only takes a couple of more 100,000, it's going to go platinum, but it's well beyond gold. We're celebrating the fact that it is gold here. Well, let me do that for you. I'm pretty good at it.
Go for it, JJ. I mean,
yes, mate. I used to do this when I was in college. 45-degree angle. There we go.
Can't teach that.
Can't teach that.
We're on location in Montreux, Switzerland. Not bad, eh?
I've been running about with
girls passing by.